Sterilization and disinfection. First, what is sterilization? Sterilization is a process by which an article, surface or medium is freed of all living microorganisms, either in vegetative or in spore state. Next, what is disinfection? Disinfection is destruction of all pathogenic organisms. Methods used for sterilization: physical agents and chemical agents. First, physical agents. Dry heat. This includes flaming, incineration and hot air oven. This is important. Hot air oven. Moist heat by boiling steam at atmospheric pressure and steam above atmospheric pressure. Filtration using candles, asbestos pads and membranes. And fourth is radiation. We'll see all these in detail in this video. Chemical agents include alcohols, phenols, aldehydes, ortho-phthaldehyde, parasitic acid, hydrogen peroxide, hypochlorous acid, dyes, halogens, surface active agents, and gases like ethylene oxide and formaldehyde. We'll see the details of these in the next video. Let's see the physical agents one by one. First is heat. Heat is the most reliable method of sterilization. It is of two types: dry heat and moist heat. The mechanism of killing, that is the lethal effect of dry heat, is protein denaturation, damage by oxidants, destroying cell constituents, and toxic effects of increased electrolytes. For moist heat, the lethal effect is by denaturation and coagulation of proteins. The time required for sterilization is inversely proportional to the temperature of exposure. Let's now see about dry heat. First is flaming. Flaming is sterilizing inoculating loop or wire, tip of forceps and searing spatulas. So for sterilizing all these things, flaming method is used. Next is incineration. This is done for destroying biomedical waste and plastics like PVC, polyvinyl chloride, and polythene. Hot air oven. This is very important. Hot air oven is the most widely used dry heat method for sterilization. The principle behind this is conduction. Mechanism. The heat is absorbed by the surface of the item, which then penetrates to the center. The entire item reaches the desired temperature, and a fan is fitted inside the hot air oven to ensure even distribution of air and for the elimination of air pockets. Let's see the holding period for different items to be sterilized. Most common is 160 degrees Celsius for 2 hours. This is for sterilizing glassware, forceps, scissors, scalpels, all glass syringes, swabs, fats, grease, liquid paraffin and dusting powder. Next, 150 degrees Celsius for 2 hours. This is for sterilizing sharp instruments like those used in ophthalmic surgery. Next, 150 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. This is for sterilizing oils, glycerol and dusting powder. And the oven is allowed to cool slowly for about 2 hours before opening the door. This is a picture of hot air oven. The sterilization control for hot air oven. Physical. Temperature monitoring by thermocouples. Chemical is using a Brown's tube. Green color is produced after 60 minutes at 160 degrees Celsius, or 115 minutes at 150 degrees Celsius. The green color indicates complete sterilization. Next is biological control. Here, heat resistant spores of non-toxigenic strain of Clostridium tetani or Bacillus subtilis subspecies niger are used. They indicate efficiency of sterilization. Let's now see about moist heat. First, temperatures below 100 degrees Celsius. First method is pasteurization of milk. This is done by two methods, holder method and flash process. In holder's method, the milk is heated at 63 degrees Celsius for 30 minutes. Or in flash process, milk is heated at 72 degrees Celsius for 15 to 20 seconds, followed by cooling quickly to 13 degrees Celsius or lower. This is done for destroying the non-sporing pathogens. Inspiration. This is done for sterilizing media such as Lowenstein-Jensen media used for Mycobacterium species and Loeffler serum slope. Here, the media is heated at 80 to 85 degrees Celsius for half an hour on 3 successive days in an inspissator. This is a picture of inspissator. Next is temperature at 100 degrees Celsius. This includes boiling. The vegetative bacteria are killed almost immediately at 90 to 100 degrees Celsius. Hard water should not be used for boiling. Should not. Addition of 2% sodium bicarbonate to the hard water may render it soft, thereby making it suitable for sterilization. Next is steam at atmospheric pressure at 100 degrees Celsius. For this purpose, Koch or Arnold steamer is usually used. Next method of sterilization is tyndallization, also called as intermittent sterilization. This is done for media containing sugars or gelatin. Here, the media is sterilized at 100 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes on 3 successive days. So, 1, 2, 3. 100 degrees Celsius for 2 for 20 minutes and 3 for 3 successive days. Easy way to remember. Next is principle of tyndallization. The first exposure kills all the vegetative bacteria. Later, the spores germinate and they are killed on subsequent exposure to 100 degrees Celsius for 20 minutes. Next is steam under pressure. For this, autoclave is used. This is again important. Two types of autoclaves are available: gravity displacement type and high vacuum sterilizers. The high vacuum sterilizers have automatic cycle control. Principle of autoclave. When the water boils, its vapor pressure is equal to that of surrounding atmospheric pressure. When the pressure inside the closed vessel increases, the temperature at which water boils also increases. This generates steam, and the steam comes in contact with the cooler surface. It condenses and transmits its latent heat to that surface. The large reduction in volume sucks in more steam, and the process continues till the temperature of that surface equalizes with that of the steam. So this is the principle of autoclave. This is a picture of an autoclave, and these are its parts as indicated. The sterilization in autoclave is carried out at temperature between 108 degrees Celsius and 147 degrees Celsius. Used for sterilizing materials like linen, instruments, laboratory ware, media and pharmaceutical products. So for sterilizing all the culture media, autoclave is used. Next is sterilization control for autoclave. Physical and chemical are same as that for hot air oven. That is, physical is temperature monitoring by thermocouples. Chemical is using Brown's tube, where green color is produced indicating complete sterilization after 60 minutes at 160 degrees Celsius or 115 minutes at 150 degrees Celsius. The biological control used here is Geobacillus stearothermophilus. This is used as test organism in autoclave. Next method used for sterilization is filtration. The filtration removes bacteria from heat liable liquids like sera and solutions of sugars or antibiotics. The types of filters, they are candle filters, which may be further of two types, unglassed ceramic filters or diatomaceous earth filters. Next is sintered glass filters and membrane filters. The candle filters are widely used for purification of water for industrial and drinking purposes. Sintered glass filters have low absorptive property and can be cleaned easily, but they are brittle and expensive. The membrane filters are used in water purification and analysis, sterilization and sterility testing, and for the preparation of solutions for parenteral use. This is a picture of asbestos filter, and this is a picture of sintered glass filter, and this is membrane filter. Next is sterilization using radiation. Radiation is of two types, non-ionizing radiation and ionizing radiation. Non-ionizing radiation are low energy. Ionizing radiation have high energy. Non-ionizing radiations include infrared rays and ultraviolet rays. The infrared rays are used for rapid mass sterilization of pre-packed items such as syringes and catheters. The ultraviolet rays are used for disinfecting enclosed areas such as biosafety cabinets in laboratories, entryways and operation theatres. Next, ionizing radiations include gamma rays, X-rays and high energy electrons. Since there is no appreciable increase in temperature in this method is referred as cold sterilization. The ionizing radiations are used in commercial plants for sterilizing plastics, syringes, swabs, catheters, animal feeds, cardboard, oils, greases, fabric and metal foils. Especially the gamma radiation is used. So these are the physical agents of sterilization. We'll see about the chemical agents in the next part of video. Thank you.